Hello, hi, welcome to another video. Today we are going to see the operation of an alarm valve and motor gong assembly in a fire protection system. Coming to the overview of the video, we will be discussing clapper valve arrangement, clapper valve with retarding chamber, assembly of an alarm valve, normal operation of an alarm valve, operation of an alarm valve during surges or pressure drops, operation in case of fire, inspection and maintenance, and also we'll be seeing about false alarms. Now let's see what is an alarm valve. Alarm valve is a double seated clapper check valve with groove seat design, which ensures positive water flow for alarm operation and is designed for installation in wet pipe sprinkler system. In system with variable pressure, retarding chamber is added to trim the standard operation. What you're seeing in the screen is a clapper valve operation without retarding chamber. As you can see, during the normal operation time, the area of the clapper which is subjected to the system pressure is slightly higher than the supply side pressure. This design allows the clapper to resist the water surges and other minor fluctuations without opening. In the second one, you can see alarm valve in open position, allowing the water to flow directly from the supply side to the sprinkler side, which might be probable outcome of a fire. Now we can see an alarm valve with a retarding chamber. This is the most commonly used one. This is manufactured with a hinged clapper equipped with a torsion spring to assure the proper operation. Minor flows resulting from the small surges will pass through the external bypass trim to minimize false alarms. During the sustained flow of water, hinged clapper moves out the seat to open position. In the event of a variable pressure condition, false alarm is prevented with the provision of a retarding chamber. Thus allows the operation under both variable and constant supply pressure condition. When retarding chamber is used, water entering the grooved alarm seat port is directed to the retarding chamber. Temporary surges or fluctuations which are not large enough to move the valve clapper are automatically drained through the restricted drain. External bypass prevents false alarm under all supply pressure conditions. Operation of one or more fire sprinklers causes the water to flow into the sprinkler system, causing the alarm valve to open and allowing the continuous flow of water into the system and the transmittal of alarm. The alarm can be electrical and mechanical. The electrical alarm is given through a pressure switch and the mechanical alarm is given through a motor gong bell. Now what you are going to see is how an alarm valve is assembled. This is a typical connection diagram for an alarm valve. You can see point number 17 shows the two number of pressure gauges which are connected to either sides of the clapper plate through an angle valve, which is used to show the pressure at both supply and system side. The bypass is connected through point number 2, 29 and 18 through rigid piping. A normally closed point is available at point number 10, which ensures the bypass operation and allowing the pressure difference to compensate without passing through the retarding chamber. Point number 20 is a restricted assembly which allows surges to pass through once the water gets filled in the retarding chamber. The retarding chamber is connected between point number 1 and 32. The outputs of the retarding chamber are connected to a pressure switch for electrical actuation, and through a vice trainer it is connected to a motor gong alarm for mechanical actuation. Vice trainer provided at this junction ensures that clear water is passing through the motor gong. Now let's see the operation of an alarm valve in three conditions. That is normal, surge and an operation. First we are going to see the normal operation. The main purpose of an alarm valve is to ring a mechanical bell called water motor gong. Under normal circumstances, clapper valve is closed, blocking the alarm board and maintaining system pressure, and also prevents the sprinkler system water from leaking back to the supply line. Under normal condition, the water pressure gauge connected to the system side of the alarm valve would show a higher or equal pressure reading than the water pressure gauge connected to the supply side of the valve. This occurs because of the bypass line connecting the downstream and the upstream side of the alarm valve is allowing the water pressure surges to pass without lifting the valve clapper from its seat. This feature allows to release the excessive high pressure surge which is entrapped in the system side due to the presence of check valve. Restriction assembly located beneath the retarding chamber consist of an inlet and restriction orifices which are established by considering the volume of the retarding chamber to meet the listing and approval requirements regard to the alarm. In constant pressure insulation, the retarding chamber is not required and the water is passing through the groove in the alarm ball seat, flows directly through the restriction nozzle assembly and will be activating the mechanical and electrical alarms. Now, let's see the operation of an alarm valve in case of a surge condition. Here, the clapper of the valve is just opening, allowing the water to enter into the alarm port and the retarding chamber is starting to fill. If this were a just surge in supply, the retard chamber would fill partially only and the pressure at the pressure switch would not reach the required pressure and the device would not trip. There must be an automatic drain in this line to allow the water to drain and to drop the pressure back to zero so that the pressure switch can reset after a surge or an activation of an alarm. Since the retard chamber consists of metal containers that are constantly getting wet and drying out, they require maintenance to make sure that the drain stays clear and doesn't get clogged with rust or corrosion. If a surge doesn't drain from the retarding chamber before another surge happens, the retard chamber may fill and will cause the pressure switch to send a false alarm. On the left side of the alarm valve, there is a bypass line with a check valve and two pressure gauges. This allows small surges to pass through here, which helps to avoid building up the system pressure, which causes excessive wear and tear on the clapper of the alarm valve. Now, let's see an alarm valve in open condition. When a sprinkler bulb is fused in a sprinkler system, the alarm valve will remain in open position due to the water which is flowing out through the open sprinkler. The water filled in the retarding chamber is being discharged through the water motor gong bell and which will create a mechanical alarm. The pressure switch will be tripped as there is a pressure in the alarm line and it will last until the water flow is stopped. Now, let's discuss about the installation requirements for an alarm valve. The alarm valve must be installed in a readily visible and accessible location and provision to be made in such a way that the alarm line is visible and accessible. Care must be exercised while installing a check valve in the trim to ascertain that they are located with an arrow mark on the check valve body and are pointed in proper direction. The contraction and expansion associated with an excessive volume of trapped air could cause the waterway clapper to cycle open and shut. This may result in false alarm or an intermittent alarm. To avoid this, it is recommended to have a breather valve in the system piping network and a vent valve at the extreme end of the system to bleed off the air. And also, we need to ensure that the bowl valve which is provided on the alarm line must be kept open and strapped in set position. Now, we can discuss about the inspection and maintenance of an alarm valve. Inspection and testing is to be carried out only by an authorized person. Open the alarm test valve and verify that the sprinkler alarm bell and the pressure alarm switch are properly actuating. Close the alarm test valve and verify that the water has ceased to flow from the alarm drain. Ensure that the strainers provided on the alarm line and the restriction assembly are clean and clear. Now, let's see about some false alarm conditions. If pressure switch is giving a steady signal, but sprinkler alarm is giving an intermittent alarm, we need to check the alarm bell shaft. If both sprinkler alarm and the bell are giving intermittent signals, then we need to check for the possible air which is trapped within the sprinkler system. If the alarm is not working, the impeller may be jammed. Also, we need to check for clapper face rubber beadings to prevent false alarm. This was all about the working of alarm valve and motor gong assembly. Hope the video was informative. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe my channel for more informative videos. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you.